Do you?
Yeah. Hey, McKenna. I heard you weren't feeling well, so I made you some soup. She's gonna be so grateful. I can't wait to see the look on her sweet... Tucker, is that you? Come over here. Oh, you brought me soup. How sweet. Just keep telling yourself it's still McKenna. McKenna's arms, McKenna's body, McKenna's... lunch.
Well, set it on the porch.
So, what are you?
A witch.
Uh-huh.
Don't you touch my homemade treats. If you want candy, go out and beg for it like a normal kid. See where rebellion gets you? Come on. Cough it up.
I'm not choking. Just have a little throat tickle.
You saw McKenna yesterday. After I specifically told you to leave that soup with her mother.
I held my breath the whole time, I swear.
I bet you took credit for my chicken noodle, too. Well, you are not going to infect this family with influenza B. None of us have had our shots yet. Move away from the candy. I have another can under the sink. Don't move.
Hi, honey. Why do you smell so lemony fresh?
Step away from the boy, Jeannie. He is a hotbed of disease.
Tucker, cut out.
See?
Tucker, honey, open your mouth. Oh, your tonsils are the size of tether balls. You saw McKenna, huh?
She needed me.
Mm-hmm. Come on, up to bed.
Mom, no way. I feel fine. I'm going to a Halloween party tonight.
Not unless you wear a boy in the plastic bubble costume.
But McKenna's gonna be there, unescorted. She's all better now.
I'm sorry, honey. There'll be other parties.
I guess I am a little tired.
And I don't want Leon anywhere near that sick room. You have got to be absolutely isolated.
Claire, be reasonable. He's got a cough, not leprosy.
Reasonable is not making him sleep in the garage.
Wait, Mom, she's right. There's no reason Leon should be exposed to my germs. I think I could handle having the room to myself for a few days.
Okay. I'll be up in a minute with some tea and cough drops. It says dispense generously, not ridiculously.
Ha ha. This stuff kills germs. And I will not let that child infect my Jimmy or...
Open your mouth.
Oh, don't be silly.
Open. Looks like somebody else needs to be quarantined.
That child did not just ruin my Halloween. I've got to dispense my homemade treats to all the good little boys and girls.
No, no. We can't have you infecting the whole neighborhood. Now, if Leon can't sleep with Tucker, and Jimmy can't sleep with you, then the only way... Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
It's not so bad. I just got off the phone with McKenna's mom. Apparently, this strain of influenza B runs its course in about 24 hours. Don't worry. Between the fever, delirium, and nausea, you'll hardly notice each other. I'm gonna go get your stuff.
Stay on your side of the bed, mister.
And in keeping with the Halloween theme, we're bringing you a creepy crab corner marathon all night long here on the Crab Channel.
You will not use the pillows, blankets, or sheets as tissues. You will not make noise or have the light on if I'm sleeping. and you will keep all drool inside your mouth. And Jeannie, I want you to check on us every 20 minutes to see if I need anything.
Maybe she should stay away. We don't want her to catch it, too.
Oh, I'm sure she's built up immunity from that job. All those people breathing on you and touching you.
I work in a restaurant, not a strip club.
Oh, and I want you to fumigate Leon's room for Leon and Jimmy. Typhoid Tucker has undoubtedly left his mark in there, too. Great. The trick-or-treaters are starting to arrive. We haven't even gone over the rules yet.
Why bother? It's not like you'd ever know if I actually followed them.
You're kidding, right?
So what are the rules?
No time for all of them. The main things to remember are, don't be too generous. That candy has to last all night. And be sure to take notes on who's appreciative enough and who wasn't. It'll count for next year. Oh, that reminds me. The Kaplan twins get nothing. And hurry up before they TP the house.
Hey.
Nice costumes.
You like them? I'm Captain Casual.
And I'm Señor Leisure.
And together we are very comfortable. If it bothers you, we can go put some clothes on.
And ruin your costumes? Why aren't you guys out trick-or-treating?
Well, the lad and I discussed.
You're not even sorry, are you?
Aunt Claire, I'm sorry I got you sick, okay?
But you're not sorry you went to see McKenna, are you?
You wouldn't understand.
Let me give it a try. You think that if you're persistent enough, McKenna will eventually dump Seth Green and realize that you are really the right guy for her.
Not even close.
Uh-huh. Well, let me save you a lot of time and grief. She is never gonna pick you over that rock star.
Actor.
Whatever. A boy like you isn't supposed to be with a girl like her. She's in a different league.
What do you mean, a boy like me? Look, Aunt Claire, I'm sorry if the captain of the football team or the student body president passed you over for the head cheerleader. But whatever painful memory you're drawing from here does not apply to me. I know exactly what I'm doing with her. I make every second with her count. I pick every word carefully.
Really, Tucker? Must we always talk about you? It's getting boring already.
You brought it up!
Uh-uh. Oh, come on, man. We want candy.
Come on.
Oh, you...
Okay, honey. Just a fever. It's okay, Claire. Only good dreams.
Wow! Let the debauchery begin.
Reluctant to come any closer.
hear they're more scared of us than we are of them.
I thought you guys might be hungry.
Hey there.
Oh, it's my Jimmy.
How you guys holding up?
I feel fine, Jimmy. Bit woozy, though.
Don't you worry. You'll be feeling frisky again before you know it.
Oh, Jimmy, not in front of the waffle.
Maybe we ought to let them rest.
So, Leon, let's see how you like being bashed around.
All snuggled up in bed together. Don't worry, I'll make copies for you guys.
Jeannie, sweetie, it's okay. I forgive you.
Right. You guys are in the fever stage. Next stage is worse.
Tell me the truth, Jeannie. I know you kissed my boyfriend, didn't you?
Yeah, probably. Which one?
Billy Wagner. After prom? I saw you two talking. I know you two made out.
He was your boyfriend? That dirtbag! Well, we can't let him get away with this. Do you still have his number? I don't care if this was like 50 years ago. You should know how you feel.
I love you.
I know.
Billy, how dare you take advantage of my little sister? Oh. Oh, well, tell your daddy he better watch his ass. Claire Winnick is nobody's doormat. The hell I will!
That little boy has a mouth on him.
See, Aunt Claire? I can get a girl like McKenna.
Got it right now. As much as I'd like to stay and mess with you guys all night, I've got a party to go to.
Wait, I'm coming with you.
Oh. Oh. Ah. Waffle?
You got a little something there.
Hey, my last toilet paper cozy vanished under mysterious circumstances. I don't want anything happening to this one.
McKenna was here?
Uh-huh. Dressed like a mouse.
I hope I didn't say anything stupid.
Well, I only recall bits and pieces. But it sounded pretty romantic to me.
Really?
Yeah, I think it was something to the effect of...
I guess, Tuck...
Tonight was fun and all. But I don't think I could live like this full time.
Yeah, I gotta agree with my son on that one. Without Claire's discipline around here, this household would collapse like a badly built fort.
But tonight's not over. You wanna come try out our fort, Aunt Jeannie?
Yes, I would.
But you're gonna have to strip down your underwear first. Dress code.
No.
And I was so close.
You really weren't. Well, what I mean is, look, let me just tell you a little story about love.
I knew I wasn't gonna get out of this without a story.
Hey, I'm trying to help here.
Is it about Billy Wagner?
Oh, my God.
Can we get back to me now?
Yeah. When I was in college, I fell madly in love with this really incredible guy. He was smart and funny, so handsome. I mean, I was always a looker, but this guy could have anybody he wanted. He was way out of my league, much like McKenna is to you. But, like a fool, I pursued him. Now, at the time, he was an officer in the Air Force. So one day, I went down to the base to...
Wait a second. You're talking about Uncle Jimmy.
I know.
So you actually got him. You're saying I've got a shot.
Oh, Lord, no. I'm saying we can't all win the lottery. What are the odds of it happening twice in one family? Are you feeling feverish again?
No, I just realized how dead wrong you are. You could not be more off the mark if you tried.
Well, you don't have to be rude.
Aunt Claire, you do know that according to Uncle Jimmy, he's the one who hit the lottery. So, your analogy's sound, but the interpretation is all wrong. See,
Tucker, you're an okay kid. Maybe you do have a shot with her. But if you tell anybody that I called Billy Wagner and cursed out his youngest son, I will tell McKenna's mom the whole doggy thing.
Deal.
And if you're good, maybe I'll take you out tomorrow for a nice game of fetch.
Oh, sounds like fun, dancing queen.
My mom, and she said I could either have a dog now or a car when I'm 16. So I picked the car. I hope you understand.
Look, McKenna,
I'm just playing with you. Don't worry about anything you said.
So you're not mad?
No way. You couldn't help it. And that fever's like truth serum. Your true feelings just come pouring on out.
So, that explains the stuff you said to me when you were feverish. Nice.
You want to refresh my memory?
I think we both said enough.